The lights are low. I'm sweaty and my heart's beating at a rate I can't take. You're close, but so far, lifting more and more weight. Squirt, squirt, clean it up. It's too late now. I'm done. Wipe it down for the next go around. I'm over this gym workout. I need a Kit Kat break.
All right, well, I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Thank you. I just want to thank everyone for coming out tonight. Be sure to make... Thank you, Bongo Bobby. That's right, it's Bongo Bobby, guys. As I was saying, I just want to thank you. That's enough. There's a time and place. Please stop it. All right, so... Well, thank you guys for another amazing night at the Digs. Remember that this weekend we're gonna have the poetry show and our own roomie is gonna be headlining, so it's gonna be pretty cool.
Wait. Wait a second, that roomie didn't get to perform tonight and you said that she could. Come on, man.
Okay, calm down, sorry. Hey, roomie, why don't you come and perform for us?
Oh, you know, I don't have to. Everybody was ready to end.
Oh, come on, don't let my forgetfulness deter you. Why don't you come perform?
Yeah, please. You gotta perform. I mean, where else am I going to get my inspiration from? You're so amazing.
Okay, cool it on the group, Joe.
It's Joshua! And she is amazing. Spectacular. Roomie.
Okay, you convinced me, I'll perform.
Falling leaves that have gone astray. Yet I, we, people, hurt your mother with our ashtrays and cigarette butts. Butts that are dirty. Butts that stain the earth. When will we clean ourselves with the TP of truth? Al Gore said it was inconvenient. Well, I say, let's not be so lenient. You take a stick and wave it at a dick of the corporate world. This is just a metaphor, of course, because they're all pussies. Thank you.
All right, guys, thank you for another wonderful session. And don't forget about this weekend.
Spectacular! Spectacular!
So you were the one making all that noise back there.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah, it's fine. Just remember, quietness was friends.
Come on.
So what can I help you with?
I was wondering about membership for the poetry group.
Oh yeah, I think that would be fine. If you want to be a member, all you have to do is talk to a quick book. I think you'd be a good addition. I can tell. I can see it in the eyes.
Thank you. I'll be happy to be a member.
Yeah, just remember, quietness was friends.
Very good. Hey, LaQuiqua. Matt told me to come talk to you about Poetry Club membership.
I'm Jean. Racist.
I'm LaQuiqua.
Membership.
I'll get you the paperwork.
An honest mistake, I guess. Unless you're really racist, then hey, man.
No. Quality for all men and all.
Oh, gosh. Don't try so hard.
Your poem was?
Spoken word.
I'm sorry?
It's spoken word. I don't do poetry. Poetry is about alliteration, antithesis, and anapest, and all that garb. Spoken word is, it's theater, life, art, all rolled up nicely for the audience to take a hit. Spoken word is about the atmosphere, the message.
Sorry, that was a mistake.
Hey, it's okay. Everyone makes them. And you don't have to apologize so much. You're a human being.
Sorry, I mean... Sure, your spoken word was fantastic. It really spoke to me.
Oh, thank you. I mean, you know when you let your emotions, your happiness and anger and angst guide your pen? It's beautiful. You should do your own spoken word.
No, I'm an observer. I'm part of the audience.
I'm not hearing a good excuse.
I'm completely new. I don't have anything to write about. You want to hear.
Still not hearing a good excuse.
I've just recently got into the spoken word. I'm a complete newbie. What should I write about? I don't have any experiences or things that I should say.
Oh, well, when did spoken word touch you?
Just now when you were saying it.
Oh, man. I'm happy to inspire.
Happy to inspire.
Excuse me.
Oh, Rumi. What an amazing performance. How do you do it?
Life, man, it just speaks to me in beautiful ways.
You're beautiful.
Thanks. You're being creepy again.
Oh, sorry. It's just that I'm so awestruck in your presence. Which reminds me, you inspired another poem of mine. It's called A Letter.
Dear one and only, or the one who makes my dreams real and reality phony, what I'm about to say is true, not baloney. Fantastic, beautiful, goddess of truth are a few words that come to mind when I think of you. Figure of pleasure no other can and should measure. This is a letter to the incredible soul who inspires this poem and my soul. Soul to soul, I receive your message.
You can't be tamed, and I, so unworthy to speak your name. You're a hairstylist of art and literature. Please do me. With an updo of your grace, do me.
This is a letter to the incredible Rumi.
Thanks, Joshua.
You're welcome.
That was so visual.
Well, I just want you to know how much you mean to me.
Oh, it's pretty clear now.
Those are all compliments, music to my ears.
So, Brandon, is it?
Yeah.
And are you a spoken word artist?
No.
Then what are you doing here?
Well, I'm a freshman.
That you are.
Easy, Joshua, let him breathe.
Sorry, it's just, you know how I feel about posers.
He came to check us out, and now he's becoming a member. You know, I still think you should do your own spoken word.
I thought you said he wasn't an artist.
Not yet. But when I'm done with him, he'll be a true spoken word professional.
Well, you know, I'm really excited about your performance this weekend.
Oh, Brandon! You should do one this weekend!
That's really short notice.
Yeah, short notice.
Nonsense! It'll be the perfect christening into spoken word performance.
Okay. I'll think about it.
No. You'll try it.
Rumi, I think Matt wants to talk to you.
Oh. Excuse me.
What are you doing? Sizing up my competition. Means my back off.
Looks like it didn't fit in nicely.
She was a hipster. She was a hipster with hips. Okay, that was done. She's a hipster with hips, and those hips went all the way down to her thighs. And those thighs would swing, dip, and grind. Not on me. Okay, not bad, not bad. What the hell, man? What are you doing in here?
Oh, I was having a congressional meeting. What do you think I was doing? I was taking a poop. Not bad on the poem for a first timer. It's still pretty shitty, though.
Thanks, Joshua.
That's what I'm here for, to teach the incompetent. But if you're trying to impress Rumi, you're gonna have to work harder. She likes deep men, reflective, smart men, something that you're not.
Thanks for the advice, but I think I'll just take my chances.
Okay, but don't say that I didn't warn you. When you're sitting all alone on a Friday night, eating Chunky Monkey on your couch, just remember that I warned you. Rumi has a type, and that type is not you.
What is that type then?
Me! Well, I mean, it will be. Whenever I blow her away with my poems, she'll be begging for more, Joshua.
What's up with you? Am I always this type much of an ass?
Only when people get in the way of things that I want. And I want Rumi. We belong together. Soulmates. You don't break up soulmates.
I care about Rumi. We had a real moment the other day. Actually, we had a couple moments. Every time I looked into her eyes, I felt a connection. Every time she stared into my eyes, I felt
horny.
Complete. Everything you ever wanted or you dreamed of was right there in front of me.
Wake up, lover boy, because that's not going to happen. You and Rumi are not getting together if it's the last thing I do.
Who are you to say that? I mean, really.